Otherwise, I'm taking minus two all damage. I just messed up. I don't know what I'm doing. You know what? Is this guaranteed? This is guaranteed, isn't it? It's guaranteed. Let's just do this. Oh my goodness. Hey everyone, I'd like to apologize in advance for the Bumblefish stuff I've been doing in the past few days. And in all honesty, this is actually my third time recording this. And that's because, well, if I wasn't already starting a new 9 out of 10 loop, I'll just say right now, then as I roll this and we'll go on with the challenge. Basically, yeah, I failed another loop without even... It's not a video that's out. If I'll cut to it, I may cut to it now. But if I don't cut to it, then just know that I've failed two challenges in a row. One because I pretty much disqualified myself, and the other because, well... I died and I underestimated the challenge that I'd rolled. Otherwise, we will be on this video right now. The rules are on screen. Please pause. Yeah, we're on the Battle High Challenge. Quick play, True Believer, Sun Death. And I'm going to take it a little slower because, yeah, I'm basically referring to my own rules and trying not to ruin myself. So if I am going to go over the rules, I'm not repeating it. So it's more for myself just to make sure I can try to do the challenge, because I've tried that twice in the past, and one, I completely messed up my own rules and failed one challenge, and then the other challenge I underestimated and got myself killed because I lost concentration, and yeah, it wasn't good. Anywho, yeah, so fighting a lot of enemies in the Battle High Challenge. Spider God, Medical History, all perks. Mimi, I almost said Moriko for some reason. And I wasn't even Moriko any of the previous runs. If I do include them in this video, then this is, well, should be my third run of the video. It's oof. Oof, big oof. Let's see here. What do I want to do? I need to get into at least 20 encounters and only 5 count per run. Ghosts must be severed, so, I mean, unlike the Ghost of Shiokawa challenge, I need to sever all of them. So I can't use splints. I just have to literally use the scalpel if I have still have the scalpel after the end of this run. It's not good. Takashi-san. Light. Dexterity. Strength. Again, I'm not going slow for padding content. I'm going slow for my own sanity's sake. Takashi, and this is actually something else. So usually the second mystery check, but... yeah, I'm not going to pass the strength or dexterity unless I put stats into them, but I'm probably not going to, and that's going to be unfortunate for my lighthouse checks. So, need to run into at least 20 encounters. I think Takashi-san does, yeah, they do count if the rules say, so whatever is on screen for the rules do take priority over anything I say right here, right now in video. So if whatever rules that you were looking at are going to be what applies for the challenge, and maybe I might change them in a future episode because, but that will be more because it makes more sense rather than, oh, it's too hard, because I'm not like that usually. Eels, Coma, Festival, Mermaids, Footage. So we should run into Takashi-san, so that takes care of one encounter. We will take Eels anyway because, the mitigation is too good. Medical History, Spider God, my most hated one. If you haven't noticed, or it's not apparent from the last run, I did have Spider God in my... I'll just say it. The second run was the Bewitched one, and I went to schools first, and I completely forgot I had a police revolver. So I ended up trying to kick Scissor Woman to death, completely forgetting that I had a gun on me because I picked it up. I underestimated my Bewitched challenge, let's just say. Or what was that? No, it wasn't Bewitched. It was, weakest... No, it was Bewitched, because I think I took a mystery first, and then I... Well, I can't remember. Maybe, like I said, if I cut to it, you can correct me. I have been a little out of it as of recent, and maybe that will account for the Bumblefish I've been doing, but... Oh, nice perception check, by the way. I rolled a 12 against Mimi 7, by the way. Yeah. I guess one thing I would probably add to myself for Battle High anyway is that if I'm on the last challenge and I don't have enough, then I can break the 5 encounters per mystery limit. Because technically encounters are harder in the last mystery anyway, so there's no point making it quote unquote impossible for me to pass. So if it's the last mystery, I can do however many I want, but until the last mystery, I can only 5 encounters per mystery count towards the 20. if that's the case, because I, like I said, Takashi-san is technically not in a mystery, but he's an encounter, so I'm willing to count him. Unfortunately, I'm not running into very many encounters, so yeah, that last mystery is looking pretty bad for me. The scalpel is not the worst weapon in the world, but I still think it's below average. Again, it's a free weapon, so I'm not really complaining. It's just when I look at the stats and what it can do to most enemies, especially with mystery scaling, it does have its downsides. Of course, like I said, it's a knowledge weapon in Mimi, and it comes free with Mimi, who has high knowledge, so I shouldn't complain, but the facts are facts. I could change city history, but I'll keep waiting on that. Need to make sure I don't die as well. Maybe I should actually keep... So if you hear me clicking in the background and the mouse in World of Horror isn't moving, that's because I'm keeping a count outside for the sake of Battle High specifically, so that I don't lose count. Otherwise, obviously I could do it in post-edit, but I'm doing the challenge here recording right now. I kind of need to do that. Yeah, bosses count towards the total as well, but I think for survivability's sake, I might complete the challenge, but I'll just end up dying in the run, so I don't complete the challenge. Let's go festival. That way we can do some free rests. We'll actually do some village investigations, because I need to run into count encounters, and not all the village encounters are bad on average. Unfortunately, I have all perks, so I can get things like deft handling, which is just kind of odd. Minus the 410 billion event. I might as well make use of this. I could start stacking into strength, both for strength checks and for the lighthouse, so let's do that and hope that I don't get injured anytime soon. That's going to be 4% faster actions, so it's fine for now, but choose room for clues. Nope. Why?
I rolled an 11 against Mimi's 8.
Oh, why do stats matter? Also, that hurt my knowledge, so it's a good thing I don't have the knowledge check, and it also helps with Mimi. So I have average knowledge right now. Of course, it's gonna hurt my scalpel speed. It's gonna be down to before I could guarantee 2 prep attacks. Now I can't. So oh, now I decided. Well, I did get Thread of Fate, so my RNG is kind of tipping back in balance. Of course, I still need to run to an encounter, but. You know, so this is finally my first encounter. Hooray. Kiniko Gatherer, though. If I defeat it, of course. Which I will plan to. No, I can still do prep attack. Oh, that's right, because I have fame. So, yeah, with fame, I'm at least able to do this. Of course, since I'm on my first or second mystery, the HP scaling allows me to not three-shot him, which I would be able to do if Festival was my first mystery. So, that's unfortunate. I'm also on medical history, and I can't run anyway. And I don't plan to buy any pocket knives, so this is going to be a bit of a big oof. Don't get injured, please. What did I just say? Ow, my ribs. That's not good. I think Kinugo Gatherer has his own thing, maybe, but we'll just get out. So that was a 4 turn, but yeah, nothing much I could do. I can't run. All I have is a scalpel, and my knowledge got killed by brain damage, so I really need some good luck. Yeah, that was not good. If I lose reason here, I'm going to die, so you know what? In that case, I'll put all 3 videos in here. If not, like I said, I'll probably just make a cut. Decide what to do me in the future, because I'm dying so fast right now. Anyone is free to give me some what I could have done. So, in fact, I'm not. I don't actually welcome backseat gaming in terms of, well, you should have done this or that. But I mean, if it's valid criticism, I'll take it and grit my teeth because, I mean, facts are facts. Even if you hate something, if you're completely wrong, if I'm completely wrong and someone tells me what to do and I get mad at that, that's kind of childish of me. So. In the end, tell me what I could have done differently. I mean, I can definitely think of what I could have done differently, but trying to open my mind to new possibilities would be very interesting. Should I change city history? Right now, I have the default. So, dog shop, police station. But I need to fight enemies, so... And I've only fought one so far out of two mysteries. Oh, this is not good. I think I'm going to die here. But let's, like I said, let's always struggle till the end. It's not over till it's over. But yeah, and then I have hardware store. Yeah, there's not really any reason for me to city history right now, so we'll keep what we have, keep our bath, and be in a lot of pain right now. We don't even have enough funds to get rid of these exposed ribs. Mermaids, oh, I don't want to fight the boss, but I only have one encounter out of 20. Two if we count Tuxi-san, assuming I kill him. And then we have coma footage. Oh, this is all bad. This is really, really bad. Do I want the fire axe? At this point, since I raised my strength up to 7, but I have to be able to kill them. I took it anyway. Oh my goodness. I need to find 19. Can you believe that I streamed this? Or, well, at the very least, we have the Burning Man to save us here. So let's definitely make the most of this free encounter, this breath of fresh air. Breath of flaming fresh air. Oh, this is really oof. Oof, big oof. So, yeah, this is a really... In the meanwhile, if anyone wants to comment how I'm editing my videos, feel free to tell me how you think, because I'm pretty... with how I've recorded within the past few hours, I feel really confident that my choice of editing this video that you're watching right now, because this should be in a video, is going to be pretty interesting. And my main reason for that is because I normally like to leave everything in one take so that no one thinks that I'm like, oh, he actually like kept rolling RNG and looked at his challenge or something to that. And I know that sounds like paranoia, but I mean, for me, it's more an ethic choice for me. But if I make edits like this, I mean, and they're ultimately disadvantageous towards me, I mean, then I guess there's no real hurt to it, right? As I said, I failed the last two challenges I did. That was not part of the previous episode. So this should be more than enough improvises, but I'm just going to keep going as I throw these at him. Because, yeah, I need all the help I can get. I think I'm even going to sell this man. Nope. Let's do that. And let's hope that... Because actually, yeah, it's more important for me to keep these, keep damage on me right here. Again, let me just update this count in the background. So this is my second encounter out of 20 on my third mystery. If I'm planning for this challenge run specifically for Battle High, what I want to do is actually run into as many encounters as I can. I probably should have just waited around and did investigations not related to the main investigation. That way I force myself to run into encounters that are not scaled up, but it's too late now. I'm already in real life, I'm here, so I can't do anything else. So yeah, I'm on my third mystery. Maybe I should just start here because at least the damage scaling isn't so high. I have like 18% doom, so I do have doom to spare. And I have ammunition in the way of all these broken bottles and branches. I wouldn't throw the scalpel. The scalpel only does one damage, so I might as well keep equipping it. That way it's more damage, quote unquote. That said, this is a mermaid. Do I want to run into the... Yeah, let's run into the... No, let's hold downtown for now. Max threat level downtown, by the way. So let's spam school. Hope we don't get a bad feeling. Pick up this book. Fatal Flora, that will be okay for... assuming that my storage isn't bugged out, which it is. Which means that Fatal Flora would have been nice to hold on to, but since it disappeared into the aether of my storage, can't use it. But again, having these branches and broken bottles are ultimately more damage overall. So this is my third encounter. I'm just going to assume I go through with these. So that's why I'm kind of making it easy on myself in terms of counting. But yeah, let's see. Actually, what do I get for this? Can I kill her in two turns anyway? So let's just do this. Yeah, let's just... wait, I have fame though. This is a gamble. I should be... Assuming two of these hit, I should still be okay. If two of these miss, then I'm in trouble. Okay, good. She heals life, but it doesn't matter. And getting out with minus one all isn't so bad. So, yeah. We're going to pick these up and keep... We're on encounter lockdown, so let's go to the mansion. I personally prefer mansion because there are a lot of encounters in mansion that when you look at it, aren't really harmful to you. However, there are a few that are pretty bad. Let's store this while we get the mask. That way, this doesn't disappear into the aether. Pick up this broken bottle again, and we'll keep going. After one more investigation, we're free to investigate school again. Search the room is a free item. Let's store this. When I know I'm going to pick up an item or have a good feeling I'm going to, I'll do this. I can't run from combat, but I'm looking more for the overall stat. Higher percent chance, lower damage. And that one damage is a big number because of how... just because of the overall... I'm dying too. I almost overlooked that. But yeah, because one damage, with how low HPs can be, it's one damage is actually a lot of damage. 80%... 80 speed, 6 knowledge, 52... I wouldn't be able to fit 4, which is a threshold for me. Ugh. No, I'm not tired. I just woke up. Anyway, excuse me. How much does this... Let's sell this. The reason being, I'm going to... No, my bandage disappeared as well. So I can't even sell that, but if I get pickpocketed, that's going to be really bad otherwise. We're going to pop into school, hope we run into maybe Young Witch. Young Witch is actually a good encounter when you... Nope, I'm dead right here. Quote, unquote, dead. I guess that event doesn't kill you immediately. I'm going to give myself a pass here. If I'm not on sudden death, then I don't know what to say. Let's keep going. I'm pretty sure I was on sudden death. Anywho, knowledge, please. I need this. Thank you. Leveling up will be important for battle high. Double stack knowledge. No, let's go strength again for the sake of the lighthouse. Keep going into school. I still need to grind a bunch of encounters. I have 3 out of 20. So yeah, definitely need to run into more. Again, maybe I'll add in a Doom rule, where if Doom gets too high, then I can just forego the challenge, but we'll save that for when I'm on episode maybe 26. I was hoping. Yeah, I'm starting to do the main investigations now. I kind of want to there is something I could get. You know what? Dang it, it didn't appear. Let's just pick up the cigarettes then. At least I'll have one fun so I can get pickpocketed, but that also means I have to... Let's store this. Hopefully it doesn't disappear. Okay, didn't. I got the nice ring back, so we can actually... I'll hold on to that. Just in case I get pickpocketed, as always, hold on to my ammunition, my 12 damage, and let's keep going on. Do I want to fight the man janitor? Doom for no reason, 52%, so I kind of have to rush now. Charisma. No. Why do stats matter? Let's try to spam an event for encounter. Nope. I mean, I'm thankful that I'm passing this, but still, one investigation is 1% doom. This isn't so bad. I'm actually willing to just go through with this, because it's not too much reason damage. Otherwise, I could guarantee the kill by doing something like that. If I do, so I could throw these two only. And then if the game is nice to me, I will not miss this attack. RNG! Unless it just didn't count that attack because it bugged out because I went over 200, but I doubt that's what happened. I actually just missed, 95% chance to hit? Mind you, I don't usually roll on RNG, not to that extent. I've made fun of, like, doing spicy plays, but... Well, this is why I record content. Take a ride, please. Why would it? Granted, I'm, you know what? just for the sake of the mad janitor, I'm gonna smoke these cigarettes now. What else do I have? Branch, the lump of flesh will be for healing, so I'll keep that on my inventory. Otherwise, let's do one seaside just to do this side quest. Nope. If I could ignore it, that'd be nice. But taking it home doesn't really result in anything. And like I said, I have reason to spare, so... If this... Nope. It's just this. Nice. Stamina for no reason. Can't heal anymore because I'm forced into this. Let's see what we can do. Oh, we're definitely going to throw all these. Unless... Well, let me think. Let's save that last branch in case. So I do 12 per turn. 12, 4, 6... Nah. The funny thing is, if I didn't keep the lump of flesh, and I also I have Kana mitigating damage, so I think this is my fourth encounter, right? Fourth out of 20. otherwise, well, I think this is so. Yeah, this is 16 if every attack hits. Obviously, you know what? We're already at the mercy of our gambler's fallacy. I missed that one attack. Nope. Of course, I'm gonna miss half of those. 75% chance on four attacks. Why does it matter? Let's do this again. We're all in here. So, the question now, yeah, this is guaranteed, so I think this kills him. Barring anything weird happening, but yeah, now we get the fire axe. We're actually going to equip this because this is more, still more damage to the scalp. Well, now that we have 8 strength, which is why, you know, when I was reviewing the characters, I don't really look at their stats as much because you can build any way you want. Of course, the fact that you have to up a stat that's normally lower is the trade-off. So, that said, we're going to enable Monument now, and we're going to do this. I could use the Nice Ring to get rid of the exposed ribs, but 11 max stamina isn't too bad unless... It's mainly if I need to have more than 11 stamina, which is usually not the case. You can kind of react most of the time. If I'm going to be stuck in the footage forest, that's a different story, but... Let's go home. Boop. Into boop. Footage or coma? And I need to fight 16 more... Well, 15 more encounters. Again, we got to count Takashi-san. So... And I have the damage scaling, so now every enemy does 1 damage, so they're pretty much doing base because I have Kana. Let's do footage. My reasoning is so that at least in in footage, I'm going to be stuck in the forest. So I don't want to be stuck in the forest with no way to rest, because then at least with the final mystery, I can still rest if I need to. Here's my 5th encounter, by the way, counting for the sake of the challenge, but... And with the fire axe, we get to do this. We also need to remember that we're on cigarettes, so we do need to keep our funds up. Otherwise, we're going to have a bad time. Well, it's going to balance out with fame, so I should be able to still be able to do a prep a strong attack. We'll find out, but 9 into... This is guaranteed, right? Yeah, that's guaranteed. This should kill. Yep, and we're gonna level up here, see what we get. We have all perk cards, so... yeah, that's the thing. All perk cards means you can just completely get this, and, this is probably gonna be the most useful, but... Heal reason, I know we have cigarettes, so we have more reason than we'd have, but, we're gonna do the 2 investigations, then go head back to mansion. Get another mask, hopefully, do I want to? 4 max stamina, so I'm going to have 7 max stamina, because that stacks on top of exposed ribs. Is it worth it? Is it worth it? Is it worth it? What's my last mystery? Coma, was it? There are some enemies that have 25 HP on the 5th mystery, which means if I do a strong attack with the, with the fire axe, and then I do a regular attack with the fire axe, then it's not gonna be enough. Well, it is gonna be enough if I happen to gamble on strong attack, normal attack, and then do a normal attack, maybe a strong attack. But of course, that first turn has to go well. If I only do a strong attack, normal attack, into a normal attack, that's going to be for 24 damage. Correct me if I'm wrong. Of course, no one could correct me. I'm recording this by myself, but you know what I mean. Yeah, so that to that end, we're going to keep the demon mask as well. Scalpel does sell for one as well. You know what? Yeah, actually, let's... I misclicked. Well, at least we get to have the holy candle. I didn't want to, but since we accidentally went in there, I had no choice, so... Yeah, mistakes like that, kind of important to not do, but I'm just gonna take it. Lump of flesh, we'll save that. No, actually, we should probably just use it now. Don't give me a bad curse, please. Curse signs, not gonna use spells, so that's okay. We do have Threat of Fate, I forgot about that. I should use that for the Mana Janitor, but anywho, too late now. Keep the Holy Candle, because if we do run into certain events, we can lower our doom, which we will need to do because we still need to do a bunch of encounters. I will say now, though, if I get to the point where I want to change the rules, I'll probably just be adding a global rule where if my doom rises to a certain point, then I can just forego the challenge and complete the run. That threshold will probably be very high so that I don't make things too easy, but you know what I mean. I usually take the wine here. Hungover isn't too bad of a status effect, so... Yeah. Hopefully I get out of this forest. If it so happens that I run into encounter after I run out of cigarettes so that I'm on withdrawal, I will actually be mad. I might even just switch to another... You might even see me post up other content for a while because I'm just so flabbergasted at my luck. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. Another curse, more brain damage. Nice. I didn't need my that stacks, unfortunately, so my knowledge is now at 5. You know what? We might as well drink this now and get hungover. That's gonna hurt my quote unquote hurt my how fast I am in battle, but am I really going to run out of cigarettes? Okay, good. I did run into one of these first. Of course, I could always run into another encounter after I run out as well, but at least for this encounter, I have the cigarette buff, which may or may help me do things. So, I could do this, but yeah, this might be a one-shot, and she's doing 2 stamina damage, so let's go for it, shall we? Let's go for it and see if we miss 85% even once out of the 3. I was about to say. Anywho, yeah, we were going to run out of cigarettes, and if we don't get out of this forest, we're going to be in a very bad way for in encounters. We might as well go for it. Anywho, yeah, let's keep going. Give me an encounter. I do need RNG to be on my side somewhat. 82% doom with only 6 encounters, though. 92% doom. I think I'm dead here. 1 mystery left. What's my last mystery? Coma. You know what? We're gonna keep going. And if I don't get 20, I'm at least gonna finish the run. I'm gonna consider the challenge failed. But again, it's not over till it's over. So let's just keep going. Coma here. Pick up the cigarettes. Vending machine cigarettes so that we can do this. Goes into the storage. I was going to empty bottle in the bath. I forgot to do that as well. That's optimization that I forgot to do. That's my fault. Anywho. But I'm kind of out of it because I knew I failed the challenge. We're not going to visit village for the sake of completing this run. However, I'm just interested to see how many encounters I'm going to run into. Yeah. And yeah, we're gonna probably end it here. So this is my 7th encounter, Ghoul. I do have the cigarette buff, so I should be able to do something like this. And feel good about it. 85, 85, 95. So let's see. Missed 85% once. Nice. That was probably due to the medical history. So, yeah. More max stamina. So if I was wearing the demon mask, I'd be in a lot of trouble. Oh, missed 85% twice. 15% of 15%. I love RNG. Seriously though, what's going on? I have to monument, otherwise I can't survive the run just off the bat. We're probably gonna die to stamina damage in the lighthouse if things stay the way they are, and I get locked out of bath at the end. But let's just keep going, shall we? That's Doom. We need to actually get rid of Doom, but there's no really real way to do that. Forgetting spells is reason I can at least forget the Threat of Fate spell. However, my Doom is... Do I have it branded? No, I don't. I do have Takashi-san as well, so I actually want a monument again, because, yeah. Running into Takashi-san, he's probably gonna get one attack off, maybe. We'll see. Purposely check the freezer, that way I can run into another encounter. Again, I'm not gonna run into 20, that's not gonna happen with how much Doom I have. So, and then severed the ghosts. So I kill her in 2, but she does 2 reason damage before she dies, so... And we keep going. Again, if I fought this Dream Devourer, if I did the village side quest as well, which you need to do so, I'm not going to, so I'm not going to get to. And I'm probably, I think I have the light check as well, so I'm going to die to Reason in the Lighthouse as well. That's 2% Doom, and yeah, we're going to die here. Let's Monument just to stave off as much as we can. 4%. We're probably at the threshold anyway. Again, gotta remember that I have Takashi-san as well. This is my 9th encounter. I do kill her in a good amount. I do 2-shot her, but as I just said, oof. Big oof to this challenge and surviving the run. So we mush through this. I die here because letting the patients die does reason damage. But I heal in the bath and I'm perfectly fine. I'm gonna take this empty bottle out just to do so. So I can get extra healing in the bath. However, I'm probably going to die to the lighthouse. If not from Doom, then from reason damage. Because I think I'm failing a check that does reason damage. So, Holy Candle is useless. Well, I can use it to regain reason. So that's my last chance. And I have the Karakusa Mask to throw as well. Into lighthouse. Blim, 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 blim. Light. I do have the light check, so... Enter the lighthouse, and let's see how far we get. Again, I'm going to count Takashi-san right now. So that's the second mystery, which should be festival. Again, 2 Takashi symbols usually means the second mystery check. This is 3 reason damage. This is the dexterity check. I've passed the strength check, so I should be fine. And my last one is Takashi-san. Here. So we're gonna throw all these at him. So I did 10 out of the 20 for battle high, but I survived the run, but I didn't do the challenge, is what I'm saying. So yeah, he dies here. Thankfully I had the ammunition. Maybe I would have killed him anyway, but yeah, that's I survived, but I didn't complete the challenge, so that's definitely a failure of that. If you made it to this end of the video, I hope you enjoyed me suffering and making a few mistakes. There are a couple of key mistakes I made, but in terms of actually completing the challenge, I don't know what I could have done differently besides try to camp the first 2 mysteries, but in that case, if I don't run 2 encounters, then there's nothing really I can do about it. But that's just how hard I'm putting it, making it for myself. If anyone else wants to do these challenges, I'm not going to force you to do them. I'll probably put it, I'm thinking of that Doom rule that I just said during the course of the video, but that'll probably be in place after I struggle a lot more. So yeah, definitely not yet, but we're nearing the threshold. We are nearing that threshold where I'm probably going to have to make this easier. But in that case, it's based on my decision. Ow, I hit my hand on the desk. Anyway, if you made it this far, I'd like to thank you for watching. If you want to comment or say something, then feel free to do it in the comment section below. I look at them, and hopefully I don't miss out on any. And yeah, if you have any suggestions, feel free to put them in the comment section below as well. You know how to support me. Please support me if you want to. And that should be it for now. JRNMML. I'll be back.